So I'm about to head up to Brentor, which is on the fringes of the Dartmoor National Park. Now, if you're into landscape photography in the UK, you will have almost certainly seen or maybe visited this particular church. The church itself is very small, but the location, the place that they've chosen to build it is incredible, and in my view it cannot be beaten. As far as churches go in the UK, this one is my absolute favourite. So I'm going to go up there and see what I can get. To be honest, the weather's not looking amazing. There's a lot of low sort of rain cloud hanging around, a bit of sunshine coming through, but not very much. So in terms of a sunset, I'm not really expecting one, but I'm actually just want to get out of the house, really. The weather down here in Devon over the summer, over this summer, 2021, has been really rubbish. They're really rubbish, apart from 1 week of just insane heat wave. And then it went back to raining, being extremely windy or whatever. So it's not been great. I'm just going to go up there, go up to Brentor and just see what I can get, really. Wish me luck. I got massively stuck in traffic coming out of Plymouth. Argyle had just had a home game, actually. It was just finishing, I have no idea what the score was. But it's taken me a lot longer than I'd hoped to get here. However, as we've just come down the road there, the site of the church, I've only been here once before and I've forgotten just how stunning it is. So the wind has kicked up a little bit, as you can probably hear. Try and get out the sun. I'm just gonna cross the road to the church. The car park is the other side of the road. I was about to say main road. It's actually pretty middle of nowhere rural. On that side of the road, you are not in Dartmoor National Park, but on this side of the road, you are. The reason I mention this is within Dartmoor National Park, they have banned, via a bylaw, they have banned drones, which I'll refrain from giving you my opinion on that. But yes, this is a particular shame, because if I show you where I'm headed today, you'll realise immediately that it is the perfect location for some sweeping drone shots, which we're not going to have today, sadly. So, through the gate. This here is St. Michael de la Rupe Church. I'll spin you around. Built on top of the only tor in the vicinity here. Wait till we get up there. You can see for miles in every direction. It's such a good spot. From the top of the hill here, there is just an endless view in all directions. I'm just setting up my tripod here behind me with the intention of shooting the classic view of St. Michael de la Rupe Church here at Brentor. Last time I was here, I got incredibly lucky. It was a day where I'd had a good day, I'd been elsewhere and I'd had a good day and I'd come here, and it didn't really look like much was going to happen in the way of a sunset, and I thought, well, I get a couple of reasonable shots, that'll be all right. Never mind if there's not, if the light isn't good. I'd actually been out for something like 15 hours. I'd been out shooting the dawn in the morning and stayed out all day.
So I got amazing light in the morning as well. So I wasn't banking on it for the evening. It didn't look like it was going to happen. And without warning, the whole sky just went pink from one horizon to the other. One of the most amazing sunsets I've been in. And actually, I'll include a couple of the photos, because when I look at them now, it doesn't look real. It looks like I've faked it. It looks like I've been in Photoshop applying goodness knows what to get the sky to look like that. But I promise you, that was what it looked like. All I've done is restored the color in Lightroom. It was incredible, and I was stood right on this spot. So if we get 10% of that tonight, I will be over the moon. We are actually right now getting some nice light. Sun's over there, spilling onto this side of the church, which you do at obviously this time of day. But it's also, because of the clouds, there is also some fantastic patches of light and shadow all across the moors to the west, and that is my favourite kind of light to shoot on the moors. So I'm going to see if I can include that as well. If I shoot really wide angle it pro at 24 mils, it will probably look too far away, but I'm going to give it a go. So always lose my lens cap. Going in this zipped pocket. Starting to wonder if I might be slightly too late whilst I was time-lapsing there, because the sun is about to dip behind a big cloud bank, so let's try and be quick here. So this shot is going to be focused somewhere in the near ground here, and oh, and there's my sun dipping. It's going to f16, and I'm just going to use a grad and d filter just to take the edge off the sky, but nothing else. I want to keep the light pretty much as it is. I'll give that a shot and see how we get on. Just while I was getting set up there, the sun has gone behind a cloud. The moment I got sorted, it's not the first time, it won't be the last, but it has killed the light for as far as I can see that way, which is at least 10 miles. Still a little bit to the northeast. I'm hoping that it comes back out sometime soon before it sinks properly behind that cloud bank, which is substantial. That could really kill the evening, but it's part of the it's part of landscape photography. Plus, I wasn't expecting anything amazing, so but that was my fault. I've spent too much time messing around with this camera. That's what was going on there. But I just thought, oh, it's nice and sunny here. You know, it'll be fine. Sun looks like it's well and truly gone. I've waited about 20 minutes. It's also getting more and more windy, but the forecast said the wind was going to die right down at this time. Not happening currently, so I'm currently just having a bit of a break, trying to exercise some patience. Pays off in this game sometimes, so I'm here now. So the only thing I can do is wait and see what's what, see what happens. I've taken the camera off the tripod for the moment because it's howling, but it has actually, now I've just started recording this, the wind's died down, just to be awkward. So we shall see, we might get lucky. There might just be that one shot. Aside from the church itself, which looks great from this side, it looks great from that side, it looks great from down below. From the tour, there are views, as I say, views in all directions and potential shots from the tour, certainly facing west for sunset. Going back to the last time I was here with the crazy sunset, I did actually get some good shots in that direction as well, facing sort of due west, with the gentle rolling of the hills and with a sunset that looks unbelievable in the pictures. So not sure we're going to get that again, but there are images to be had here if things go my way. We shall see. I'm going to wait it out. I'm here now. I've waited for about 40 minutes since the sun disappeared, and it did start to look like some sunset colours were developing, a bit of orange, a bit of yellow over to the west. Sadly, there is a huge grey cloud bank that extends for as far as I can see that way, which I'd suggest is probably about 20 miles, and it is slowly moving across from the southwest to northeast direction and is destined to cover everything that you can see behind me. What I'm going to do is, if the cloud bank doesn't cover the whole sunset, I'm going to shift around to the other side of the church, which is quite difficult to shoot. And the reason for that is you are in such close proximity to the church on the top of the tor that by the time you get far enough away from it to actually get it, even with the 24mm, to get it in the full thing in your shot, or enough of it in your shot to make an image, you're actually then descending back down the other side of the tor. There's not a large area at the top there, and it makes it quite difficult to shoot. With that said, doesn't mean it's not doable. So that is my plan currently. We've just had a couple of big blasts of golden sunlight where the sun has come out from behind the cloud bank without warning. I've just had to scramble there to get the camera back on the tripod. I'd taken it off because it was windy and I was thinking about moving to the other side of the church. But yeah, just fired off some shots quickly there. I didn't have time to get this camera up and running to tell you what it was that I was doing. Mostly I've taken the sort of obvious shot with the focus in the foreground, f16, church in the back. I've got 24 to 70 mil on here, but I couldn't really get, even with 24 mil, I couldn't really get wide enough to get a lot of Dartmoor in the background. In terms of the light, things are looking quite a bit more optimistic now. We're starting to get a bit of colour in the cloud, even though it's a lot of thick low cloud, doesn't really lend itself well to sunsets. So there might be something, who knows. I'm feeling a little bit more optimistic. I had considered just sacking it and going home, but that's not how you get good shots, so I'm still here. Yeah, who knows, if there is a moment, it'll be a fleeting one. The sun will vanish pretty quickly with the amount of cloud around once it's properly going down. But yeah, I'm going to shift to the other side of the church now and see what we get. There is suddenly pink in the sky away to the north. All is not lost. So, out of nowhere, we've just got a big pink sunset. I had a mini panic, ran up and down the hillside here, firing off shots at random. I think I've got something, maybe, we shall see, but absolute treat in terms of the rest of the sky is just dull grey, and yet this area over here just went massively sort of dark pink and orange, the colours that you really look out for at sunset. So grateful for that, and hopefully I'm gonna have something to show you when I get home and get the shots on the laptop. As I've mentioned before, behind me here the hill slopes away quite quickly. It's difficult to get the angle because you end up looking up at the church, so it's not the easiest to shoot. I think we've got something. Fingers crossed. Hello everyone, I am now back at home, sat on the roof terrace in the sun. It's a couple of weeks after I was at Brentor photographing the St. Michael de la Rupe Church. On the day, I let it get too dark to give you my thoughts on the shots that I'd got. By the time I got back to the car, it was almost completely dark, and the ISO on my little GoPro couldn't handle that light level. for me to film anymore. So I've been doing a couple of other shoots since then. I had a couple of big edits, so I've just got chance now to really have a look at these photos. There are a couple that I'm really pleased with, and this one in particular, I didn't think too much of the foreground at the time. I didn't think I was really getting that much from it, but there's just the sense of the path, which isn't very well trodden, leading up the hill there to the church, which is then positioned at the back of the shot, but is still sort of the main focus. So it leads you into the photo. And of course, we've got the great light from the sunset across the middle of the picture, as well as some moody clouds and the wizened trees bent over from the constant westerly wind that you get up at Brentor. Really make that picture for me. So really pleased with that one. The other that I'm very pleased with is this one, which is same kind of idea, but from further down the tor, looking along the edge of the tor in a northerly direction. The church is the main focus, but again, it's positioned at the back of the shot, and the edge of the tor kind of leads you up to that. And obviously, we got really lucky with that great light, so very, very pleased with those two, especially as I wasn't really expecting anything. It was just really a trip to get out of the house, so great results as far as I'm concerned. That's it from me, folks. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button if you've enjoyed this video, and subscribe if you haven't already. I will have a few more of these videos for you, especially as I have a trip to Snowdonia and Anglesey planned next week, so really looking forward to that. In the meantime, stay safe. I will see you all soon. Take care.